So in this video, we are going to talk about the salient features of RA9285. So RA9285, it is also known as the Alternative Dispute Resolution Act of 2004. So please take note of that. So here, this act is also known, or it was created in order to institutionalize the use of alternative dispute resolution system in the Philippines and to establish the office for alternative dispute resolution and for other purposes. So yun po yung sinabi dyan. So with that, nandyan na po yung PICCR. Okay, it's because of this law, meron na po tayo yung mga or different organizations that are or that caters alternative dispute resolutions, okay, or that promotes alternative dispute resolutions such as the PICCR. And then later on, we are going to add more, or we are going to recognize more of those as we proceed in this topic. Okay, so take note also, please don't forget that PICCR is under the Integrated Bar of the Philippines. So it is under the IBP. Okay, just take note of that. So actually, RA9285 composes different chapters. So we have here chapter 1. It is all about the general provisions. Okay, so under general provisions, here we have some definition of terms that was presented in RA9285. So let us try to familiarize all those terms. So first one here, we have the so-called alternative dispute resolution system. So what is this alternative dispute resolution system? Under this law, it was defined as any process or procedure used to resolve a dispute or controversy other than by adjudication of a presiding judge of a court or an officer of a government agency. So simply, it is outside the court, okay? Or if not the court, outside the Senate, okay? Because it was mentioned, officer of a government agency or presiding judge of a government agency. Okay, so take note of that. And then here, in which a neutral third party, so yung meron po tayo dito, yes, it involves also a third party, however, it should not be a judge, okay? Or it is not an officer of a government agency, but we call them as the so-called arbitrator, the mediator, a conciliator, a facilitator, and a negotiator or whatsoever. So with that, we have here it gives us also here some examples of it. So it was mentioned there, arbitration, mediation, conciliation, early neutral evaluation, mini trial, or any combination thereof. So that was the definition of alternative dispute resolution that was stated under. So here we have now the so-called mini trial. So what does it mean? A mini trial, it says here, a private consensual process where the attorneys for each party make a brief presentation of the case as if it is a trial. So with that, we have the so-called we have here a neutral advisor, wherein he will be the one to evaluate those presented by the attorneys of different parties na yon. Okay, so dito wala pong mangyayaring decision. It is only more on recommendation. So merong recommendations lang na ibibigay dito yung neutral advisor na na-assign nila or napili nila. Okay, or yung nag-evaluate doon sa presentations ng attorneys ng both parties na yon. Okay, so yan po yung tinatawag natin na mini trial. So it is outside the court actually. Okay, so here we have also the so-called ENE, or the term as early neutral evaluation. So here, the disputing parties submit their case to a neutral evaluator also through a confidential evaluation session. So it is somewhat like the mini trial also. So the neutral evaluator considers each side's position and renders an evaluation of the case. So the contracting parties can include the ENE clause in the contract. Okay, so here, the ENE, it is usually also included in contracts or in making of contracts between different parties. So with that, in the future, if there is a conflict or if there is a dispute that will be exist or that will exist, then under that contract, kapag sinabi po dyan na they are mandatorily, okay, or they will mandatorily avail or go with early neutral evaluation, then that must be followed. So this early neutral evaluation, this is usually included in contracts between different persons or different parties. Okay, so there, which represents their agreement to submit to E&E in good faith or to resolve any contractual dispute. So this is also somewhat the previous topics that we have mentioned, the so-called binding and then non-binding arbitration. So it is somewhat related there. So ito po yung sinasabi natin na early neutral evaluation. Just simply, there is a neutral neutral evaluator wherein he will just evaluate those what we so-called case, okay? Or the case of those parties, and then he will be giving some recommendations, and that recommendations, if it will be agreed by both parties, then that will be followed. Okay, pero kung hindi, then maybe that's the time they are going to submit it to another ADR, or if not, they will proceed it under the court or in courts. Okay, so that's it for E&E. And then we have here the ADR provider. So as I've mentioned a while ago, one of those were mentioned a while ago, the PICCR. When pag sinabi po natin ADR provider, it means institutions or persons accredited as mediator, conciliator, arbitrator, neutral evaluator, or any person exercising similar functions in any alternative dispute resolution system. So here, some of the ADR providers that we have found here is somewhat the OADR, or the Office of Alternative Dispute Resolution, and we have also here Philippine Dispute Resolution Center. So those are only some of the ADR providers that we found. Okay, so anyway, napakarami pong ADR providers sa Pilipinas. Okay, so here, next is the so-called ADR practitioners. So who are these ADR practitioners na tinatawag natin? So under RA 9285, we have here individuals acting as mediator, conciliator, arbitrator, or neutral evaluator. Okay, so it pertains to the person itself. Unlike a while ago, it pertains to a juridical or natural person, the ADR provider. So it could be institution or a single person. Pero dito, we have here ADR practitioners, yung tao mismo na tinutukoy natin. So they can act as we are pertaining to mediator, conciliator, arbitrator, or neutral evaluator. So that is ADR practitioners. And then this time we have the so-called authenticate. So authenticate, it is somewhat to sign, execute, or adapt a symbol or encrypt a record in a whole or in part intended to identify or to identity the authenticating party and to adapt, accept, or establish the authenticity of a record or term. So somewhat it is a sign, a signature, or just a symbol in order to say that this document is considered or is somewhat considered as original also, or it is somewhat true. Okay, so that is what is meant by authenticate. Okay, so next one is the so-called arbitration. So arbitration, it was we have already discussed about that when we have our previous videos. And in this part, the definition, let's try to look on the definition that was given by RA 9285. So we have here, it means a voluntary dispute resolution process in which one or more arbitrators appointed in accordance with the agreement of the parties or rules promulgated pursuant to this act. So, resolve a dispute by rendering an award. So, ano yung award na tinutukoy natin na yan? Or the so-called arbitration award, or yung decision ng arbitrator. Okay? And then, we have also mentioned the different types of it. The non-binding arbitration and binding arbitration, and then the others. Okay, so here, it was emphasized here, voluntary dispute. However, we have the so-called binding, wherein if it is in contract, I mean the mandatory arbitration, if it was provided in the contract of the parties in the beginning, then that should be followed, okay? Or they will be undergoing mandatorily arbitration. So, however, in this law, we define it as voluntary dispute resolution, okay? So, voluntary, it is in the agreement, okay, of the parties. Because, but in the first place, they have agreed, right? So it is still voluntary. In the first place, na bago nila pinirmahan yung kontrata, they have agreed that they will be undergoing in the future, if there's a dispute, an arbitration, right? So it is simply, or it is still considered as voluntary, hindi po yan mandatory. Okay? However, to differentiate, just don't forget those two, mandatory arbitration and then consensual arbitration that we have talked about the last time. Okay, so this time we have now the so-called arbitrator. So itong arbitrator, simple lang naman po yan. Alam na ninyo yan. Pero tignan natin yung definition ng RA 9285. So here, it means the person appointed to render an award alone or with others. So it could be a group of person or yung tinatawag natin na arbitral tribunal. Okay, so means the person appointed to render an award alone or with others in a dispute that is the subject of an arbitration agreement. So that is what is meant by arbitrator. So here we have now the so-called award. So under this act, it was defined as any partial or final decision by an arbitrator in resolving the issue in a controversy. So simply, the decision that was given by the arbitrator. Ito po yung sinasabi natin na award. So sometimes it is termed as what we so-called arbitral award. So that's it. So take note, partial or final, because we have the so-called binding and non-binding arbitration, di ba? Meron yung binding wherein the decision of the arbitrator cannot be appealed already. So it is final. However, partial, or in other words, the consensual. So it must be agreed upon by the party before it will be implemented or enforced. Okay, so next we have here the so-called commercial arbitration. So it covers, under commercial arbitration, it covers matters arising from all relationship of commercial nature, whether contractual or not. Okay, so it is about, it is somewhat related to businesses. Okay, businesses, contracts, and others. And here we have the next one, confidential information. So confidential information, any information relative to the subject of mediation or arbitration expressly intended by the source not to be disclosed. So these are any informations that were brought out during the mediation process or arbitration process. So anong yung mga informations na yun na bring out ng different parties, dun lamang po yan. Okay, so we consider those as confidential. So hindi po basta-basta na yan ay dapat isiwalat or ipagsabi ng ating ng mga participants. It's either nung kabilang party. So hindi po niya basta pwedeng ipublicize yan. So it is treated as confidential. Pati na yung mediator, hindi niya basta-basta or hindi niya dapat basta-basta kinukwento yan. So it is confidential. Okay? So all those information should be confidential. Or if not, pag hindi mo yun na hindi mo respect the confidentiality of the information, then you will be charged of the violation under this law, because we have the later on we will be discussing some of the conditions on the confidentiality of informations that was brought out during the mediation or arbitration process. Okay, says here, communication oral or written. So it's either take note, it's either oral or written. So made in dispute resolution proceedings, including any memoranda, notes, work products. So halos lahat-lahat na po of the neutral party or non-party participant. So yung tinutukoy po natin dito, any oral or written na sinabi or binigay ng arbitrator or yung third party, the neutral party. In number 2 naman, sinasabi dyan, an oral or written statement made or which occurs during mediation or for purposes of considering, conducting, participating, initiating, continuing or reconvening mediation or retaining a mediator. So anything, any oral or written statement, so that was made during the mediation, those are considered also as confidential information. So it's between the different parties. So it's either the opposite party or ikaw mismo na participant doon. So those are considered still confidential information. And we have here the third one, pleadings, motions, manifestations, witnesses, statements, if there are witnesses, reports filed and submitted in an arbitration or for expert evaluation. So those are considered still confidential information. So next one, we have here the so-called convention award. So means foreign arbitral award made in a convention state. So ano yung tinutukoy natin na convention state na yan? So tinutukoy lang lamang po natin dyan na is the so-called the state that is a member of a New York convention. So ano po ba yung tinutukoy natin dito na New York convention? Okay, so we have here the New York convention. It is actually an organization or international organization of different states. So there it is composed actually nowadays it is composed of 165 states. So out of 165, yung 163 is also member of United Nations. So yon, isa na po ang Pilipinas dyan na kasama dyan sa convention state na yan, or I mean the New York convention state. So actually Philippines was became or it was adopted by the convention, I mean the New York Convention, in the year 1967. So July 6, 1967. So take note of that. So yun po yung tinutukoy natin na convention award and then convention state. Just take note, in convention award, it is made an in a convention or a foreign arbitral award made in a convention states or otherwise the New York Convention. So here we have the next one, the so-called court. So as defined also in the as defined here in this act, okay, in relation to the New York Convention, it is referring to the regional trial court. So we are referring to regional trial court pag sinabing court ng batas na ito, okay? So we have here the next one, the so-called model law. So ano ba itong model law? So it is designed to, or it is otherwise known as the UN CITRAL Model Law on International Commercial Arbitration. So it was made in June 21, 1985. Okay, so the UN CITRAL, it means the United Nations Commission of International Trade Law. So yun po yung UN CITRAL na yun. Okay, so model law, it was actually designed to assist states in reforming and modernizing their laws on arbitral procedure. So ito po yung kaya po yung RA 9285 na ito is naka-align po sa model law na yan. Okay, naka-align po sa UN CITRAL model law na yan. So take note kasi Philippines is a member of the United Nations, or one of the member of the United Nations. That's why we are also following, we are also putting, or sabihin natin na looking into it, na yung mga batas din natin, we are aligning on the so-called model law, especially the arbitration laws natin. So nakabatay po yan sa model law na sinasabi natin. Okay, so that's it for this part. So we have here now the so-called court annexed mediation. So ano po ba ang ibig sabihin nito? It was defined in this act as any mediation process conducted under the auspices of the court. So in other words, support, with the support of the court, patronage or sponsorship of the court. Okay, after such court has acquired jurisdiction of the dispute. So meron kasi yung mga times po na yung court mismo, okay, kapag yung both parties tumiretso sa korte. Okay, pero yun, yung korte, nakikita naman yan na pwede nilang ma-solve yan, magawang ma-solve yan or maayos yan through mediation. Yung court mismo mag-order yan sometimes, or they will recommend mediation to the parties. Okay, so with that, okay, sabihin natin they conducted already, again, a mediation process, or they undergo mediation. And then still, they were not able to solve the dispute. Then that time, they decided to submit it again into court, okay, to the court. So with that, yung mga nangyari noon, the process that was conducted during that time, during the mediation process, yun yung tinatawag natin na court annex mediation. Okay, kasi meron yung support or sponsorship na nangyari, or meron yung patronage or support na naging part or ginawa ng court. Okay, in during that mediation process. So that is what we so-called court annexed mediation. Okay, and then next one, we have here the so-called court referred mediation. So ito yung minimension ko kanina. Okay, so mediation ordered by a court to be conducted in accordance with the agreement of the parties when action is prematurely commenced in violation of such agreement. Kasi meron yung tinatawag natin dito na premature cases also. Premature cases wherein they were not they did not try to solve it first on the lower court or in the barangay usually. Okay, kasi sometimes court they recommend na unahin mo nang i-solve dyan sa korte, especially if it is disputes that can be solved from ADR. Okay, so yun, sometimes yung court inoorderan na mismo nila na you should undergo or it's better for you to conduct first mediation process. So yun, yung order na yun is the so-called, or it is termed in RA 9285 as court mediation, I mean court referred mediation. Okay, so yun pa rin. However, it is also still on the agreement of the parties. Okay, so it is not actually mandatorily, that was mandatorily to be followed by the parties. Okay, so yun, in accordance with the agreement between the parties still. Okay, and then the next one we have here, the ENE that we have mentioned a while ago. So anyway, in this law it was defined any process, an ADR process wherein parties and their lawyers are brought together early in a pre-trial phase. So as we have mentioned a while ago, yun, isasubmit mismo ng lawyers nila or yung both parties yung mga proofs nila. Okay, and then that will be evaluated by a neutral evaluator. Okay, and then with that, we have here the so-called government agency. Any government entity, office, or officer other than a court that is vested by law with quasi-judicial power to resolve or adjudicate dispute involving the government and government, its agencies and instrumentalities, or private persons. Take note, government entity, office, or officer. Okay, kapag tinutukoy natin na government agency, so it could pertain, it pertains to a juridical or a natural person. So with, take note, other than court, so it is, it could be the PICCR, or if not, it could be the barangay, okay, the katarunggang pambarangay, and others, okay, or any other quasi judicial or any other office or officer that has quasi judicial power. Okay, so dito po we have the so-called international party. So simply it is defined here as an entity whose place of business is outside the Philippines. So simply it is not inside the Philippine territory, or businesses that was located in or outside the Philippines. It shall not include a domestic subsidiary of such international party or a conventioner in a joint venture with a party which has its place of business in the Philippines. Okay, and then we have here the so-called for foreigner arbitrator. So ano po ba yung sinasabi dito na foreigner arbitrator? A person who is not a national of the Philippines lang naman po. Okay, next one, we have here the mediation. We have discussed this a while ago, I mean the last video. So it is a voluntary process in which a mediator selected by the disputing parties by which or facilitates communication and negotiation and assist the parties in reaching a voluntary agreement regarding dispute. So with that, the power of the third party, or it doesn't, the third party doesn't have the decision making power or to impose an arbitral award, unlike in the arbitration. So we have here the term mediator means a person who conducts the mediation. Okay, and then we have here mediation party, a person who participates in a mediation and whose consent is necessary to resolve the dispute. Simply, the conflicting parties, okay? It's whether the husband or the wife, or if not, Mr. X and Mr. Y, okay? So, or if not, a certain juridical person against a certain juridical person, okay? Or a company against another company. So, those are what we so-called mediation party. And then, here, the next one we have here, the so-called mediation, arbitration, or MedArb. So it is a step dispute resolution process involving both mediation and arbitration. So combination of arbitration and then mediation, or yung tinatawag natin na MedArb. Okay? So, or sabihin natin, mauna muna, they are going to undergo mediation. And then later on, if they were not able to fix it through the use of mediation, then they are going to undergo arbitration, wherein there is a power of or the third party has already the power to decide over the dispute of the parties. And then the next one we have here, the mini trial, which was mentioned a while ago already. So, structured dispute resolution method in which the merits of the case are argued before a panel. Okay, meron pa rin yung nasabi natin kanina, a neutral party wherein he will be evaluating the cases or the evaluating the case that was presented or the presentations of the lawyers of the both parties. So parang court trial siya. However, hindi yung, I mean, it's the absence. Yung judge ay wala doon. Pero merong neutral evaluator. Pero hindi siya, or he doesn't have the power such as the judge. Okay? We have here the mediation party. Naulit lang siya. Okay? We have here the New York Convention. We have mentioned it a while ago. The United Nations Convention or the UNCITRAL Convention, okay, on the recognition and enforcement of foreign arbitral awards approved in 1958 and ratified by the Philippine Senate under Senate Resolution Number 71. So this is the citation or the legal documentation that was made that we are part of this convention. Okay, and then we have here non-convention award, a foreign arbitral award made in a state which is not a convention state. So non-member state of the so-called New York Convention. So with that, we have here the next one, proceeding. So if we say proceeding under this this act, it says a judicial or administrative or other adjudicative process including related pre-hearing motions, conferences, and discovery. Okay, so it is what is happening actually in the mediation process or any judicial or quasi-judicial hearings. Okay, quasi-judicial processes, proceedings. And then record an information written on a tangible medium or stored in an electronic or other similar medium or retrievable form. So whether it is typewritten, handwritten, in a paper, or if not, it is saved in a USB, it is saved in a computer, it's still considered as record under this act. Okay? So, that is for record. And then, we have here the so-called roster. So, ano po ba yung roster na ito? So, roster, it is a list of persons qualified to provide ADR services as neutral or to serve as arbitrators. So, simply listahan lang po yan ng mga tao, ng mga pangalan ng pwede nating lapitan that can act as a neutral, okay? Or as a arbitrator, okay? So, yan po yung tinatawag natin na roster. And also under Chapter 1 of the RA 9285, we have here the provisions of this, the exemplaris, okay, or the so-called the provisions of this act shall not apply to resolution or settlement of the following. So number 1 na po dyan, labor disputes covered by the PD 442 or yung sinasabi natin po na yung Labor Code of the Philippines. Okay, so an example of that is conflict or dispute between working hours, or if not overtime work, employer's contribution, and minimum case or minimum cash wage. So yung magagamit po or yung mananaig doon is or mangka-cover noon is yung Labor Code of the Philippines. So hindi po yan pwedeng i-undergo natin dito or hindi po ito scoop ng RA 9285. Okay? So, yung batas pa rin doon or yung mga provisions na masusunod, it is under the Labor Code of the Philippines. Okay? And then, we have here the second one, the civil status of a person. Okay? Whether a single or a married person that could not be solved under dispute resolution or ADR. Okay? Or it is not covered under this act. Okay, and then we have here the validity of marriage. It is usually solved inside the court. It cannot be solved on the process of ADR. Okay, so any ground for legal separation, so that is actually or it is needed to be solved on courts also. Itong divorce or in other words, divorce or legal separation na ito. Another one, we have here the jurisdiction of courts. So, it is not covered under this act. We have here the next one, criminal liability and letter G. It is correlated with criminal liability. Those which cannot be compromised. Those which by law cannot be compromised. So what are those? An example of criminal cases is murder and drug trafficking. So take note, dito po sa ADR, hindi po pwedeng mag-decide yan ng, or magsabi dyan, or mag impose ng criminal liability. Only the court, or in court only, we can solve criminal cases. We cannot solve here on the process of arbitration or mediation, or hindi po yan pwedeng makompromise. Okay? So yun po yung mga cases na hindi po pwedeng hindi po covered ng provisions ng RA 9285. So yan po yung tinutukoy ng chapter 1 ng RA 9285, the general, its general provisions. Okay, so next video recordings, we are going to continue on chapter 2 of the RA 9285. So it is composed actually of several chapters. So with that, I would like to end this video here, and then see you next time. Thank you for watching. Thank you.